wanted to come on here today. I'm gonna do an IGTV. We're gonna do a fruit and cheese plate. One of my awesome followers, Lady That Loves Lace, and my good friend Megan, this was her idea, so cheers, here we go. All right. So I usually always start with 5 cheeses. I got a ton. I go to the $5 bin at King Soopers. They have a 5 and under bin, and they're all like pre-cut in these little bitty pieces, and they're just perfect. So they're all super random. Each one I open, I'll just explain what it is. So usually I start with the cheese first. So let me cut this bad boy open. And of course, always fueled by good wine. So make sure you're drinking when you do this. They turn out better. I promise. All right, so this is a Gouda. One I don't know how to pronounce. I'm not a cheese whiz, so it's like Maraiki? Maraiki Gouda? Sure, why not? I'm sure it's gonna be really good. Okay. Cheese, let's see, we've got a, it's called New Woman. Never heard of that before, but it says it's got Jamaican jerk spices in it. So sounded amazing. Down on the west coast, I get this feeling like it all could happen. That's why I'm leaving you for the moment. You for the All right, next cheese. Sorry, people are talking. Stilton with blueberries. This is the husband's favorite, so it's got blueberries in it. It's delicious. This one crumbles really easy, so be super careful. These smaller ones, I don't even cut, cause yeah, what's the point? You can just keep them as a little block. So, bam, done. Then we're gonna do a little brie style. Let's see, this guy is Cowgirl Triple Cream Cheese. Just a little heifer. And I'll probably keep it this way too. I might cut it in like a couple little triangle things, but let's see here. I'll just do this in a couple little guys. I can see my baby swinging. His parliament's on fire in his hands. Last one, we got a Murray's Irish Cheddar. Let's open up this guy. Put your gums, and again, like this rind, I love, but this one I know falls off really easy. So, see, just like that, fell off. But I really like the rind. Let's see if we can still incorporate it. This one's real funky pieces here. On the balcony, I'm singing. Ooh, baby, ooh, baby, I'm in love. I can see my sweet boy swaying. It's crazy, Cubano, como yo. We've got grapes, strawberries, apples, raspberries, blueberries, and blackberries. And then of course, at least two different kinds of crackers. Of course, I always use the Monet, the water crackers. And then I really love these guys. Leslie Stowe Rain Coast Crips. I've never tried the salty date almond ones. I usually do the fig ones, but I want to try these ones today. But they're really like fun and unique looking, and these make them look really pretty. All right. So let's place the cheeses first. So really like. Put one little ramekin, like a little bowl somewhere. You could do olives in it, your more things that roll, your grapes, blueberries. That way they don't go everywhere. And then these are gonna be just backup cheeses I'm gonna keep these. In this little bowl, even though we're doing fruit and cheese, gotta have olives. Grab a fork, all the way around my own kitchen. I hate doing these IGTVs. Well, I don't hate, but I'll get better at them. So this thing's got peppers and olives and even a little bit of meat, which I guess that's for my husband, huh? You up because I'm making food, bub. All right, and then just start laying stuff. So we'll do blackberries over here. See, real simple, no rhyme or reason. You don't want any bare space though. That's something that makes me weird. I don't know. Ooh, let's do the crackers first real quick. You gotta have the crackers on the board. Crackers. I usually like to lay them around a little ramekin guy. And yes, it's called a ramekin. So what works best actually is, so this is on like a marble cutting board, which I love. But I've seen lately people get these, they're round and they have a tiny little lip on them, like that big. So everything you put in there, there's no way it can fall out. So that makes it way easier. I've seen like wood ones that are really nice, or even a cookie sheet, because it has a little lip. You can use a cookie sheet and that just keeps everything in place better, especially if you're gonna take it to a party. That way stuff's not rolling all over the place. But this is what we have right now. So this is what we're gonna do. All right, these guys I love because they're so pretty. So pretty. Look how pretty those are. So cute. All right, and they're really, they look like little toasts, little breads. So they're super funky looking, so I love them. And then just kind of have fun with it. It's like a weird piece of art. You could even like stick them straight up. Yeah, you have to add more cheese to that, but yeah. I can see my baby swinging. His bottom's on fire and his hands are up. On the balcony and I'm singing. Ooh, baby, ooh, baby. Mess, but you can't really see it, so that's good. All right, more wine. Also, the wine today is brought to you by Carboy. This is their VIN 49. I went and picked up a little growler of it. Oh my God, so good. They are hands down my favorite winery in Colorado. Love, love, love them. They have 3 locations. I believe the first one was in Breckenridge. Then they have Littleton, which we went to. And then they have a new one in Denver, which I showed I have gone to. They're all attached to different restaurants. Amazing. Up in Breckenridge, they're attached to like a saloon. This one's attached to Angelo's Taverna. And then the one in Denver is attached to Logan Street Restaurant that we actually got to go to. And they gave us a whole tour and it was amazing. So check them out if you can. It pairs well with any cheese, trust me. All right, next. Let's get some red on the plate. Let's get some strawberries. And you can overlap things. Try not to overlap too much on the crackers, obviously, so they don't get soggy. Okay, let's do some green apple. Do a little cracker. He's so cute. Good boy. Okay. Let's get some green apple going. You really want to see that green. Let's put it over here and just slam it all in there, like my terminology. I've been drinking, it's quarantine life, so I drink every day. I really like that green. Okay, let's do some more. So I recommend have a full glass of wine before you do this because it's just gonna turn out better. It's true. That's good. What I do here with the apples, this is the first time I've ever done it, so I'm not a master, but I cut them and then kind of just like mess them all up and then just stick them. Bam. Stick them just like that. Like slide it so it looks all messy. All right, raspberries, yes, yes. Because blueberries are like, I don't know, so tiny. So this is the hard part, is getting it to stay. So this is why a little lip is just like perfect. So cookie sheets, probably the best thing. Or go buy, I'll have to post some pictures of the ones I've seen. They're like so amazing. They're on my Christmas list. See, now it's a balancing act. Nobody breathe. All right, what should we do over here? Spread this out. I'm gonna actually pull this cheese to the corner because it's more stable. More crackers. Looking pretty amazing from my view, guys. I think that's good. Beautiful.